Good morning. In today's class, let us solve one more problem in sliding friction. So the demonstration of the problem is shown here, and let me explain you the problem with the help of a diagram. Here also there are two blocks placed one over the other, but it is placed in an inclined plane, which is inclined at an angle of alpha. So the weight of the block 1 is 300 Newton, weight of the block 2 is 900 Newton. And this 300 Newton block is connected to the wall by means of a string. And the asked question is, at what value of alpha this 900 Newton block will be starts moving down because of its self weight? And they have given that the coefficient of friction at all contact surfaces is 1 by 3. That is, there are how many contact surfaces? Between block 300 Newton and 900 Newton, there is one contact surface. And between this 900 Newton and this inclined surface, there is another contact surface. So at both the contact surface, the coefficient of friction is 1 by 3. And the asked question is, for what value of this alpha, this 900 Newton block will be start sliding? And here also, we are going to analyze this 300 Newton block separately and 900 Newton block separately. So why I am going for this 300 Newton block first? Because this 300 Newton block is having only one contact surface, whereas this 900 Newton block is having two contact surface. So the number of unknowns will be less for 300 Newton block and more for 900 Newton block. So first we will go for the free body diagram of 300 Newton block. So what is free body diagram? Isolate the block from its surrounding, draw it separately and show only the forces that will be acting on the block. So the first force to be shown in the free body diagram is the self weight 300 Newton, and it will be always acting in the particularly downward direction, whatever may be the orientation of the block. And if the horizontal is inclined alpha degree, means this weight vertical also will be inclined alpha degree. So if this is alpha, if this is alpha, means this component will be 300 cos alpha, and this component along the direction of motion will be 300 sin alpha. And second force to be shown in the free body diagram is, wherever there is a contact surface, there will be a normal reaction. So this 300 Newton block is having an inclined contact surface, and your normal reaction will be perpendicular to that inclined contact surface. So this is the normal reaction R21, which will be perpendicular to this contact surface. So it will be a pointing in the upward direction. And third force to be shown in the free body diagram of 300 Newton block is that this 300 Newton block is connected to the wall by means of a string. So always a tension will be acting on the string in the outward direction from the block which is in equilibrium. So this tension will be acting in the upward direction. And this tension in this string will try to move this 300 Newton block in the upward direction. So if the block is trying to move in the upward direction, means the frictional force will be developed in the contact surface in the opposite direction. So if the motion is in the upward direction, if this tension in the block will try to move the block in the upward direction, means the frictional force will be acting in the downward direction. And we know that by definition frictional force is nothing but product of coefficient of friction and this normal reaction. And now, because of all these forces, the block 300 Newton is in static equilibrium. So we can apply static equilibrium condition. So the first static equilibrium condition is sum of the force along x equal to 0, or forces along the plane is equal to 0. So what are all the forces that is acting along this plane? One is T. So T is acting in positive of x, so plus T. And another one is 0.33 R21. This is nothing but this frictional force mu into R2. So coefficient of friction is given as 1 by 3, so it can be written as 0.33 R21. So it is acting in the negative of x, so it is minus 0.33 R21. And this horizontal component along the plane 300 sin alpha is acting in the negative direction of x. So hence it is minus 300 sine alpha is equal to 0. So keep this as equation 1. Next, apply the second equilibrium condition, that is summation of the forces along y direction is 0. So, this y direction. There are how many forces acting in y direction? Only two forces. One is acting in positive of y and another one is acting in the negative of y. So plus R21 is equal to this 300 cos alpha. Keep this as equation 2. And hence, while drawing the free body diagram of this 900 Newton block, isolate this, draw it separately, and we are going to show only the forces that will be acting on this 900 Newton block. So the first force to be shown in this 900 Newton block is self weight, and it will be always acting in the vertically downward direction from the centroid. As the horizontal is inclined alpha degree, the vertical weight also will be inclined alpha degree. So this vertical component will be 900 cos alpha and this horizontal component will be 900 sin alpha. Next, the second force to be shown is normal reactions. For this 900 Newton block, there are two contact surfaces, hence there will be two normal reactions. First normal reaction will be acting from this first block to second block, hence it is termed as R12 and it will be perpendicular to this contact surface, that is in perpendicular to this inclined contact surface, and it will be acting in the downward direction towards the center, and it will be from 1 to 2, it is R12, and second contact surface is at the bottom. So this is the second contact surface, and let this R2 be the normal reaction acting perpendicular to the second contact surface, and it will be acting in the upward direction perpendicular to this contact surface. And here, as far as this 900 Newton block is concerned, there is no any external force acting on it. The block 900 Newton will be slot sliding down because of its own weight at some value of this angle alpha. Hence, there is no external force. You need not to show any external force acting on this block 900 Newton. And as the block will be trying, or it will be start sliding down because of its own weight at some value of this angle alpha, the motion will be in the downward direction. So if the motion is about to be taking place in the downward direction, means at both these two contact surface, the frictional force will be acting in upward direction. So the frictional force at the top contact surface be mu into R12 or R21, and frictional force at the bottom contact surface is mu into R2, and both the frictional force will be acting in the upward direction since the motion is about to take place in the downward direction. And now, because of all these forces, the 900 Newton block is in static equilibrium condition. So the first static equilibrium condition is sum of the forces along x equal to 0 or forces along the plane is equal to 0. So there are how many forces that are acting along the plane in this free body diagram? There are three forces, 1, 2, 3. And both these frictional forces is acting in positive of x, and this 900 sin alpha is acting in negative of x. So hence, here at the top contact surface, the frictional force is mu into R21. So hence it can be written as 0.33 R21. So 0.33 is given in the question. Coefficient of friction at all the contact surfaces is 1/3, which is equal to 0.33. And this second frictional force at this bottom contact surface is F equal to mu into R2. Mu is 0.33. So plus 0.33 R2. It is acting in the positive of x direction. And this 900 sin alpha, horizontal component of this weight, is acting in the negative of x axis, hence it is taken as minus 900 sin alpha, which is equal to 0, and keep this equation as 3. Next, sum the forces that are acting along y axis equal to 0, second equilibrium condition, second static equilibrium condition. So there are three forces acting, that is parallel to y axis, 1, 2, 3, out of which this R12 and this 900 cos alpha is acting in downward direction, negative of y. So minus R21 and this 900 cos alpha is minus sign, and this R2 is acting in the positive of y, hence it is taken as plus R2. So plus R2 minus R21 minus 900 cos alpha equal to 0. And from equation 2, we know that R21 is 300 cos alpha. Substitute that here. So R2 minus 300 cos alpha minus 900 cos alpha equal to 0. And further simplification, you will be getting R2 is equal to 1200 cos alpha. Keep this as equation 4. So here, so if you are substituting equation 2 and 4 in equation 3, means you will be getting 0.33 into R21 is 300 cos alpha plus 0.33 into R2 is 1200 cos alpha and minus 900 sin alpha equal to 0. So now next, simplify this equation and bring cos alpha term to one side and take sin alpha term to the opposite side. So finally, you will, if you keep alpha one side, means you will be getting some 900 sin alpha divided by 0.33. So after bringing cos alpha to one side and sin alpha to another side, in the next step, divide sin alpha by cos alpha. What is sin alpha by cos alpha? Tan alpha. And keep the constant on the another side, that is 495 divided by 900. So 495 divided by 900 is 0.55. What is sin alpha by cos alpha? Tan alpha. And if you are bringing this tan alpha to the right side, tan to the right side means alpha equal to tan inverse of 0.55. So finally, we will be getting alpha equal to 28.81 degree. So this is the angle at which this 900 newton block will be start sliding in the downward direction because of its own weight.